we will study the first chapter from your history book, and the name of the chapter is How, When and Where. And in this chapter, the first subtopic is the importance of dates. Why do we learn dates in history? You know, dates are synonymous to history. Historians are fascinated with dates. And which dates? Those dates which have some specific importance. So we will learn in this the first reason for learning dates in history. The first reason is history deals with changing events that occurred over a different period of time. You have learned in class 6 book that in Paleolithic age, man was nomad. He did not live a settled life. He was hunter-gatherer. He moved from one place to another, but slowly and gradually, he learned to live a settled life. So man, from a hunter-gatherer, started living a settled life. So you see that with the different period, man learned to live a settled life. Second reason for learning the dates in history is a comparison of present with the past. We always compare the past with the present, that how life was in the past and how life has changed now. When you are traveling by the train, have you ever wondered that whether the train was there earlier also, or man had to move on foot or animals back? No, you never think. You think that in the earlier days also there was railways. But no, children, there was no train that time. It was the Britishers who brought railways to India. The third reason for learning dates in history is dates are important since they tell us when a king was born, when he ascended the throne, or when he fought some battle, or when he died. So you have to learn that when was a particular ruler born, or when he came to power, or when he fought the famous battle. You know that Akbar fought the famous battle of Panipat. So in history, you have to remember dates and on which date. And historians, how do they know that when the particular battle was fought, it was because of the inscriptions. It was because the rulers always asked the scribes to write about the important events. So the historians study and they tell us that on which date the particular event has happened. The fourth reason for learning of dates in history is we always talk of before and after. We always compare that what was earlier and what is today. So in history, we always compare past with the present. So in the next video, we will study the next topic about the same chapter, and you will also give question and you will also answer few questions which I'm going to ask in my next video.